Hello students, in the previous video we learnt about the nomenclature of alcohols, phenols and ethers. In this class let us learn about the preparations of alcohols and phenols. Let us see one by one. That is first one, preparation of alcohols. There are different methods in order to prepare the alcohols, in which the first one, that is preparation of alcohol from the alkenes. That is, alkenes is nothing but the compounds contains carbon-carbon double bonds. So these alkenes to be converted into alcohols. Let us see how to convert these alkenes into alcohols. In that first method, that is by hydroboration oxidation reaction. Hydroboration oxidation reaction. In this reaction, alkenes is treated with the diporane. That is, alkenes, for example, let us take propene. That is, propene formula CH3 and CH double bond CH2. So it is to be called as propene. So in propene treated with the diborane, that is B2H6, or it is also to be written as BH3 twice. That is, di is nothing but it contains two boranes. That is, borane formula is BH3. So when the propane reacts with the diborane, so I am going to take only one borane, that is BH3. So this BH3 is to be written as BH2 and one hydrogen. So finally it is BH3. And the reaction takes place. That is, this diborane acts as an electrophile. It acts as an electrophile. Electrophile means electron deficient species. That is, boron electron deficient atom, it has partial positive charge, and hydrogen atom having the partial negative charge, and this yields alkyl diboranes. That is, the negative part of the diborane attached to the carbon containing less number of hydrogens, that is according to Markovnikov's rule, and the positive part attached to the carbon containing more number of hydrogens. So it gives the product, that is CH3, and it is CH2, and it is CH2 and BH2, and the reaction takes place until all the hydrogen atoms from the diborane is replaced by the propene molecules. That is, let us take one more molecule, CH3 CH double bond CH2. So again one more hydrogen atom is replaced by the propene. So the obtained product here, it is to be called as normal propyl borane. So again one more hydrogen replaced by the propyl group. That is CH3 and CH2, and it is BH2. Again, the hydrogen atom attached to the carbon containing less number of hydrogens, and B attached to the carbon containing more number of hydrogens. So it gives the same type of product. So it is to be written as B twice, and it is BH. And again, it reacts with the one more molecule, CH3, CH, double bond, CH2, and it gives the product, that is CH3, CH2, CH2, and it is thrice, and B. So this product is to be called as di normal propyl borane, and it is to be called as tri normal profile borane. So this obtained alkyl borings are oxidized to alcohols in the presence of hydrogen peroxides. That is, hydrogen peroxide is H2O2 in the presence of base. That is, the number of moles required is 3 moles. Because, so the tri-normal propyl borane has 3 alkyl groups. Hence, it requires 3 moles of hydrogen peroxide. That is, the elimination of, that is, alkyl group and boron, and the hydrogen peroxides are splits up in like this, that is OH minus, and it is OH minus. That is, hydroxyl groups, 3 hydroxyl groups attached to the propyl group and 3 hydroxyl groups attached to the boron. So the obtained product is CH3, CH2, CH2, and it is OH, that is 3 moles of the propanol, plus the byproduct is B, and the 3 hydroxyl groups attached to the boron, so it is OH and it is thrice. So this compound is to be called as propan, and it is 1 OL. That is, conversion of propene into propanol. Next, by acid catalyzed hydration, that is addition of water molecules across the carbon-carbon double bonds. When alkenes, that is alkenes, C double bond, C, and remaining valences are satisfied by the hydrogens. So when alkenes undergoes hydration, hydration means it is to be treated with the water molecules in the presence of an acid, in the presence of an acid, and it is a reversible reaction. So it gives the product, that is, double bonds are replaced by the hydrogen and hydroxyl group. That is, hydrogen attached to one carbon atom and hydroxyl group attached to the another carbon atom. So these reactions are generally to be called as addition reactions. Why it is an addition reaction? Because the replacement of double bonds, that is, the double bonds are replaced by the hydrogen and hydroxyl groups. That type of chemical reactions are generally to be called as addition reactions. Let us see the mechanism of the acid catalyzed hydration of alkenes, in which the mechanism takes place in the 3 steps. Mechanism takes place in the 3 steps. First one, that is the protonation of alkene to form carbocation. Protonation of alkene to form carbocation by electrophilic attack. Of H3O plus hydronium ion, that is H2O water molecule gains one proton, so it gives the product, that is H3O plus hydronium ion. So this hydronium ion attacks to the alkene, that is C double bond C and H3O plus, that is in the H3O plus oxygen atom has positive charge because of the loss of one pair of electrons. That is, it contains only one pair of electrons. So the double bonded electrons are shifted to the hydrogen, and the bond between the oxygen and hydrogen is shifted to the oxygen. So it gives the product, that is CH2 and one hydrogen attached to carbon H, and it is single bond. So this double bonded carbon loses electrons, so it gets the positive charge and two bonds. That is, double bonded electrons are shifted to the protons, and the bond between the oxygen and hydrogen is shifted towards the oxygen, and there is an elimination of water molecules, so H2O is released. And the second step, that is nucleophilic attack of water. On carbocation. That is CH and two bonds, single bond. Carbon has positive charge, two bonds, and then attack of water molecules, H2O. That is, oxygen atom has two lone pair of electrons. So this lone pair of electrons attacks to the positively charged carbon. So it gives the product C, and it is hydrogen and single bond and two bonds to the carbon, and it is O, and two hydrogen atoms attached to the oxygen, and this oxygen loses one pair of electrons. That is, this pair of electrons is transferred to the carbon. Hence, the oxygen atom gets the positive charge. And third step, that is deprotonation to form an alcohol. Deprotonation means DE is nothing but removal of proton. The deprotonation to form an alcohol. That is C, three bonds and one hydrogen and two, and it is oxygen atom has positive charge and it loses proton. That is, again the proton is to be released by cause of the presence of water molecules. That is, the lone pair of electrons attached to the proton, and this electron shifted to the oxygen. So it gives the product CH, single bond, and it is two bonds, and it is OH. So oxygen atom gets two pair of electrons and plus H3O plus. That is, in the first step, protonation takes place. That is, proton attached to the alkene and it forms carbocation, and the obtained carbocation reacts with the water molecules. That is, oxygen atom in the water molecule contains lone pair of electrons. This lone pair of electrons attacks to the positively charged carbon and it gives a protonated alcohol. So this protonated alcohol undergoes deprotonation, that is removal of proton, to form an alcohol. In case of unsymmetrical alkenes, the addition reaction takes place in according with Markovnikov's rule. That is, the nucleophile attached to the double bonded carbon atom containing less number of hydrogens. Let us take an example of unsymmetrical alkene. That is CH3, CH, double bond CH2. So unsymmetrical alkene means there is a difference in the type of alcohols attached to the double bonded carbon atoms. Such molecules are generally to be called as unsymmetrical alkenes. So let us take propane. So when propane on hydrolysis, that is H2O in the presence of an acid, so it gives the product. That is, all these reactions are the reversible reactions. So it gives the product. That is, in the water molecules, the positive part is hydrogen and the negative part is hydroxyl group. That is, negative part attached to the carbon containing less number of hydrogens. So this hydroxyl group attached to the carbon containing less number of hydrogens. So it gives the product CH3 and it is CH. So it is OH and single bond. So it is CH2 plus one hydrogen. It is CH3. So this molecule is to be called as propan and it is 2-OL, 2-propanol. That is conversion of propane into propanol. And the next method of preparation of alcohols, that is from carbonyl compounds. That is, carbonyl compounds means the molecules which contains carbonyl group. Carbonyl group is C double bond O group. Let us see how these carbonyl compounds to be converted into alcohols. In that first one, that is by reduction of aldehydes and ketones. That is, generally aldehydes and ketones contains this carbonyl group. Let us take an example of aldehydes. That is R CHO, that is C double bond O H, and the ketone, that is R C double bond O and it is R dash. That is, to the carbonyl group, one is alkyl group and another one is hydrogen. So these molecules are generally to be called as aldehydes. If the carbonyl group attached to the two alkyl groups, such molecules are generally to be called as ketones. That is, when aldehydes and ketones are reduced to the corresponding alcohols by addition of hydrogen in the presence of a catalyst. That is, both the aldehydes and ketones are to be converted into alcohols by treating it with the hydrogen in the presence of catalyst. Here the catalysts are finely divided, such as platinum or palladium PD and nickel Ni and lithium aluminium hydride. That is and one more catalyst, that is sodium borohydride. NaBH4. So all these reagents are to be used as a catalyst in order to convert the aldehydes into alcohols or ketones into alcohols. Let us see, that is, when the aldehydes undergoes hydrogenation in the presence of palladium catalyst, so it gives the product. That is, the chemical reaction is reduction reaction. That is, reduction means addition of hydrogen or removal of oxygen atom. So here the double bonds are gets replaced by the hydrogen atoms. That is, one hydrogen attached to the carbon, and one hydrogen attached to the oxygen, and it is H. So the molecule is also to be written as R CH2 and it is OH. That is, there is a replacement of double bond. So the obtained alcohol is a primary alcohol. It is a primary alcohols. Let us see how to convert the ketones into alcohols. That is, ketones also undergoes hydrogenation in the presence of a catalyst, palladium or sodium borohydride. So it gives the product, that is R, and it is C, and it is R dash, that is two alkyl groups, and double bonds are replaced by the hydrogen, that is one hydrogen attached to the carbon and one hydrogen attached to the oxygen. So the product is also to be written as R C, and it is R dash, so it is OH and it is hydrogen. So this is to be called as secondary alcohol. That is, aldehydes on hydrogenation in the presence of a suitable catalyst, it gives the primary alcohol. And ketones undergoes hydrogenation in the presence of catalyst, it gives secondary alcohols. That is, aldehydes always produces primary alcohols, and ketones always on hydrogenation it produces secondary alcohols. Simple reaction. That is, when aldehydes and ketones undergoes hydrogenation, there is a replacement of double bonds. That's it. That is, there is a replacement of double bonds with the hydrogens. And let us take an examples. That is, R is CH3 group and R dash is C2H5 group. So write the examples for this general reactions by taking CH3 methyl group and ethyl group. Next method, by the reduction of carboxylic acids and esters. That is, carboxylic acids having the general formula, that is R C O OH. So this is to be called as carboxylic acid. So these carboxylic acids are reduced to primary alcohols. Carboxylic acids are reduced to primary alcohols by the presence of a catalyst, that is strong reducing agents, to be called as lithium aluminium hydride. And followed by the hydrolysis, it gives the product, that is R C, and the oxygen atoms are replaced by the hydrogens, that is CH2 and it is OH, that is R CH2 OH. That is, carboxylic acids is to be converted into alcohols, that is primary alcohol. And write the examples by taking R is CH3 and C2H5. And next one, that is commercial methods of preparation of alcohols. From carboxylic acids, or it is also to be called as by the reduction of esters. Let us take carboxylic acids, that is R C O O H, and these carboxylic acids are reduced to alcohols by converting them to esters. That is, carboxylic acids to be converted into esters by using the alcohols, that is R dash OH. So R dash is to be written in order to differentiate the alkyl groups. R dash OH, that is alcohols in the presence of an acid. So it gives the product, that is hydrogen atom combines with the hydroxyl groups. So there is an elimination of water molecules. So it gives the product R C double bond O, and it is O R dash. So this molecule is to be called as esters. So these esters on hydrogenation in the presence of a suitable catalyst. In the suitable catalyst, so the obtained products are, that is, there is an cleavage of bond between the CO and oxygen, and this bond is to be replaced by the hydrogens. So it gives the product, that is RC, and this bond is to be replaced by one hydrogen, and the double bonds of the carbonyl group are replaced by the hydrogens. So there is one more hydrogen, CH2, and single bond, and this oxygen and hydrogen, and the byproduct is, that is, R dash O and hydrogen. So it gives a primary alcohol, and the alcohol to be used in the first step is produced at the end of the chemical reaction. So there is no loss of alcohols by the conversion of carboxylic acids into primary alcohols. That is, first carboxylic acids to be converted into esters, and these esters on hydrogenation in the presence of catalyst, it gives the primary alcohols. That is conversion of ethyl ethanoate. That is, ethyl ethanoate is to be written as CH3, and it is C double bond O, and it is O, and it is C2H5. So it is to be called as ethyl, and it is to be called as two carbon atoms. So it is eth, and it is OATE, that is ethanoate. So this ethyl ethanoate on hydrogenation in the presence of catalyst, that is, catalyst is nickel catalyst, that is, it requires 2 moles of hydrogen, so it gives the product, that is, cleavage of bond. Here there is one hydrogen, and here it requires 2 hydrogens for carbon and 1 hydrogen for oxygen, so totally it requires 4 hydrogens. So it gives the product CH3, CH2, and it is OH plus C2H5, and it is OH. That is, it gives ethanol. Ethanol. So this method generally to be called as commercial method of preparation of alcohols. That is the commercial method, because it gives the more yield of alcohols. Hence, it is to be called as commercial method of preparation of alcohols. In the examination, they may ask, write the commercial method of preparation of alcohols. Or they may ask, explain the conversion of carboxylic acids into alcohols. Or explain the conversion of esters into alcohols. And next one, that is preparation of alcohols from Grignard reagent. So the Grignard reagent is RMGX. That is, both the aldehydes and ketones, that is, both the aldehydes and ketones has carbonyl group. So these aldehydes and ketones reacts with the Grignard reagent RMGX. That is, magnesium has partial positive charge, because it is more electropositive than the carbon, and the shared pair of electrons are always shifted towards the alkyl group, hence it gets the negative charge. That is, in the carbonyl carbon has positive charge, and oxygen is more electronegative, hence it has negative charge. So the negative part of the Grignard reagent attached to the positive part of the carbonyl group by replacing the double bonds, that is, double bonded electrons shifted to the oxygen. So it gives the product, that is, it is to be called as adduct, that is, intermediate. So it gives CO, that is R, that is alkyl group attached to the carbonyl carbon, and oxygen atom has negative charge because this double bonded electron shifted to the oxygen, and the remaining part is MgX. So this magnesium has positive charge. So there is an affinity between the negative part and positive part. Hence it is to be called as adduct. On hydrolysis, that is H2O, on hydrolysis, that is there is a cleavage of bond or affinity between the negative and positive ions. So it gives H and it is OH. So it gives the product, that is two bonds and it is alkyl group and it is OH plus of Mg, X and OH. So it is also to be written as Mg, OH, X. That is when the aldehydes are ketones, that is aldehydes are ketones. When aldehydes are ketones, reacts with the Grignard reagent, followed by the hydrolysis, it gives alcohols. For example, let us take formaldehyde, that is H C double bond O and it is H. So it is to be called as formaldehyde, or it is also to be called as meth. Because of the presence of one carbon atom, it is to be written as meth, and the nature of the bonds AN and the functional group is CHO. Hence it is to be represented as AL. So it is methanol. When methanol reacts with the Grignard reagent, that is R MgX, so that is alkyl group has a negative, magnesium has positive charge. In the carbonyl, carbon has positive charge and oxygen has negative charge. So the negative part attached to the carbonyl carbon and double bonded electron shifted to the oxygen. So it gives the product, that is H, C and it is R and hydrogen and it is O minus, and the remaining part, that is MgX, it has positive charge. Next, on hydrolysis, that is H and it is OH, so it gives the product, that is R CH2 OH plus Mg OH X. And let us take an aldehyde, that is RCHO, that reacts with the Grignard reagent RMgX. So it gives the product, that is R and C and double bond O group. So the reaction takes place like this, that is R. So let us take an R dash, that is R dash attached to the carbonyl carbon and it is hydrogen, so O minus and it is MgX plus. So followed by the hydrolysis, so the product is R C and it is R dash, so it is one hydrogen and it is OH plus the byproduct is Mg OH and it is X. That is formaldehyde gives the primary alcohol. Formaldehyde gives primary alcohol, and other aldehydes gives secondary alcohols. And ketones has a formula, that is R C double bond O and it is R dash. So ketones reacts with the Grignard reagent, that is R MgX, so it is R double dash and it is R dash. So this dash is to be used in order to differentiate the alkyl groups. So it gives the product, that is R, and it is C, and it is O minus, and it is MgX. It has positive charge, and one is R dash and another one is R double dash. So followed by hydrolysis, so it gives the product R C R double dash, and it is R dash, so it is OH. Plus the byproduct is Mg OH and it is X. That is, so the obtained alcohol is tertiary alcohol. That is, formaldehyde gives primary alcohol and other aldehydes gives secondary alcohols, and ketones always produces tertiary alcohols. And write the examples by taking R is methyl and ethyl groups, and the halogen atom is Cl, Br and I.